I believe that developmental science has done a lot to really promote ethnic diversity. And I think for future developmental scientists, especially who are people of color, they can talk about not about others, but about themselves and us. And I believe that both perspectives are really important. Looking things from outside is important, and looking things from inside is equally important. And when that's balanced, that's most important. We don't want our research become a me-search. So it is good to have the balance. But for children of color and young people of color, moving into an area where it's been predominated by others, it's important to have their presence to the field.
When I moved into the social sciences, into developmental science, the first study that I really became interested in was the work by Kenneth and Mamie Clark. And their work was extremely impactful to me, number one, as a person of color, because they were doing research on children that was asking questions about their exposure to attitudes, beliefs, etc. And I found their interpretation and the interpreter's interpretation of their science incredibly important, interesting. Most importantly, the findings really have implications for how integration happened in this country.
The human population needs to be represented in the science. We don't want a science that is saying this is the way human beings are when it's represented by white middle-class families.
We're dealing with disparities and inequality. We're dealing with segregation. We're dealing with a lot of structural issues that they're working with. And there's an important way in which we need to reframe the questions to not be always focused on problem behavior. And this is a persistent pattern sort of in the research literature. But we need to focus more clearly on resolving structural patterns that produce these inequalities, and we need to focus on really figuring out how to empower young people of color, how to identify and how to build on the strengths that they have.